Come on, sing it to me. Say you want to say. The first Sunday of the 10th month. in your life, whatever God has initiated in your life, by divine ordination, it shall be perfected. Receive it in Jesus' name. It is your season of completion. It is your season of perfection. It is your season of favor. Completeness. Hallelujah. Number two. Ten. Also signifies God's judgment against your enemies. Now, when the Jews were in Egypt, before God could deliver them, He performed 10 miracles, 10 plagues that judged all the gods of Egypt. After number 10, Pharaoh said, "Enough is enough. Go away." I tell you, every Pharaoh in your life, every stronghold in your life, in this month, as you celebrate God, something broken, and the devil shall set you free. Your captives shall set you free, because it is the season of God's divine judgment. In the name of Jesus, in the month of October, I decree divine judgment on all your pursuers. I decree divine judgment on all your opponents. It is the season of divine favor. Now, 10 generations after Adam, we're talking about the number 10. 10 generations after Adam, God brought judgment. That was in the time of Noah. He brought judgment and destroyed everything. Oh, hallelujah. But Bible says, but Noah found favor with God. I declare, it is your season of divine favor. I said, it is your season of divine favor. In October this month, may you have divine favor. Receive divine favor. Receive divine favor. Receive divine favor. In the name of Jesus. When Israel left Egypt, got to the Red Sea, the Lord told them, "This Egyptian should see this day. The Egyptians should see this day. You will see them again no more. You will see them again no more. That which has embarrassed you, in the name of Jesus, you are good. You are good. You will see them again no more. Receive absolute deliverance. Receive complete deliverance. Receive divine favor. In Jesus' name." We thank God for this man. Hallelujah. Anyway, it's a worship afternoon, amen. And therefore, I'm going to talk about worship. I'm excited. My spirit is stirred up because of what is happening in the spiritual atmosphere. There is a shaking. There is a shaking. God is bringing a new order. And one thing about the number 10, I forgot to say about that. Let me say it before I continue. It is the end of an old order and an initiation of a new order.
I declare as you enter into October,
may a new order be initiated in your life. May a new order be initiated in your family. May a new order be initiated in your finances. Oh, you have gone around this mountain for too long. It is time. The old order is closing today. I said the old order is closing today. A new order is about to be released. A new order is about to be released. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Shall we pray? Our Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for a time like this where your people can come together in worship and praise unto your name. Holy Father, who is worthy but you, we give you glory. I commit myself unto you. I pray for a filling of the Holy Spirit. Help me to deliver your word of truth with power. Help me deliver your word of truth with understanding, that your people may be blessed in your presence. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. I'll be speaking this afternoon on the subject, the power of gratitude. The power of gratitude. Shall we turn our Bibles to the Gospel according to St. Luke? The Gospel according to St. Luke. Luke chapter 17, reading from verses 11 through 19. Luke 17, 11 through 19. Shall we hear the reading of God's word? I'm reading from the King James Version. And it came to pass, as he went to Jerusalem, that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off, and lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. They lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, go show yourselves unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they were blessed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, and with a loud voice, somebody say, with a loud voice. With a loud voice. And with a loud voice glorified God, and fell down on his face, at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan. Hallelujah. Amen. And Jesus answered and said, where are not 10 cleansed, but where are the 9? And he said unto them, unto him, arise, go thy way. Thy faith has made thee whole. Amen.
Amen.
You want to read it, Dutch? Okay, just do it.
En hij geschiedde als hij naar Jeruzalem leidde, dat hij door het midden van Samaria en Galilea ging. En als hij in een zeker vlek kwam, ontmoette hem 10 melaatse mannen, welke stonden van verre. En zij verhieven hun stem, zeggende, Jezus, Meester, ontferm u ons om zeer. En als hij het zag, zeide hij tot hen, ga heen en vertoon uzelf den priesters. En het geschiedde terwijl hij heen gingen, dat zij gereinigd werden. En een van hen, ziende dat hij genezen was, keerde weder met grote stem God verheerlijkende. En hij viel op het aangezicht voor zijn voeten, hem dankende. En diezelfde was een Samaritaan. En Jezus antwoordde zeide, zijn niet de 10 gereinigd geworden? En waar zijn de 9? Zijn er geen gevonden die wederkeerden om God eer te geven dan die, dan deze vreemdeling? En hij zeide tot hem, sta op en ga heen. Uw geloof heeft u behouden.
Amen. The power of gratitude.
De kracht van dankzegging.
Nou, the account we read said,
wat we hebben
Jesus was traveling alone.
Jezus was op reis.
To Jerusalem.
Op de weg naar Jeruzalem.
But the Bible says it happened that he was going to Jerusalem.
Het gebeurde dat hij op de weg was naar Jeruzalem.
He was going to Jerusalem.
Het kwam tot stand dat hij naar Jeruzalem ging.
He passed through Samaria and Galilee.
Door Samaria en Galilea.
Now that statement makes it seem that it was by coincidence that he had to go there.
Dat het per ongeluk dat hij daar naartoe was.
That it was by coincidence that he met those men.
Dat het per toeval was dat hij deze mensen.
Verse 2 said, and as he entered into a certain village,
en als hij in een bepaalde
there met him 10 men that were lepers,
10 melaatse mannen,
which stood afar off.
En ze stonden van ver.
Now it seemed by coincidence
dat per toeval
he passed that road and met those men.
Dat hij per toeval op die weg ging en deze mannen.
It seemed by coincidence
per toeval
he was going along his way and met Bartimaeus.
Dat hij onderweg was en dat hij
Bartimaeus. It seemed by coincidence
per toeval
he went by the pool of Bethsaida and saw the lame man.
Bethsaida was in die verlangde.
I want to announce to you,
ik wil u verkondigen,
there is no coincidence in life.
Toeval.
It was a divine setup.
Het was een bovennatuurlijke
setup. It was a divine setter. This afternoon, as you are in the presence of God, to praise Him and to worship Him, it is not coincidence. There is a divine setter. There is a divine setter for your deliverance. There is a divine setter for your breakthrough. There is a divine setter for you to meet Jesus. There is a divine setter for overturning your captivity. For as you worship the Lord this afternoon, the power of God is going to come upon you and break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. It was not by coincidence. There was a divine setup. And the Bible says, as he entered the city, he came across 10 men that were lepers, and they were afar off. Hallelujah. Why would this man be afar off? Because they were outcasts of society. And the Jewish custom, when a man had leprosy, it was because that person has committed some serious offense. And as a punishment, God punishes that person with leprosy. So if you have leprosy in the Jewish tradition, everybody knew that you have done something
that
very bad.
Donald
Trump will say they are behaving very badly. Somebody, if you do in the Jewish tradition, you are behaving very badly. That was the Jewish mentality. As a result of that, such people were not welcome into the society. They were considered social outcasts. Nobody wanted to have anything to do with them. People look down on them. Because when men are talking, they do not count. But I'm here to announce to somebody, maybe society has looked down on you. Maybe in your environment you look like an outcast.
Or
maybe because of some calamity or some story about your life, people are keeping
afstand.
But I want to announce to you, the Lord is coming your way. The Lord is coming your way. And He will receive you. And He will welcome you. You know what happened to these people? Because they had a common calamity. When you study Jewish tradition, the Samaritans and the Jews, there was tension between them. So these people never did anything together. The Jews discriminated against the Samaritans. A common calamity brought them together. Everybody needs a comforter. Everybody needs a comforter. Nobody will comfort them, they will come and comfort each other. At that time, race did not come. At that time, social status did not come. They had a common calamity. I pray in the month of October, may God release your comforter. I said, let God release your comforter. May you locate your comforter. May you locate your destiny helper. There are certain things no man, some of the people around you cannot comfort you. You need someone who has walked in the same shoes and who understands your situation. May God break such help for you. In October, may you encounter your comforter. These people comforted each other. And then suddenly, they heard that Jesus was passing their way. Let me put it, they heard that Jesus happened to be passing their way, not knowing that was a divine setup. Hallelujah. In this divine setup and this divine order, in this month of divine completion, may God work the supernatural in you. your life.
Hallelujah.
They cried out to Jesus. The Bible says they were afar off. And they lifted up their voices. Verse 13, Luke 17, 13. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. You see, the people did not wish Jesus would have mercy on them. They did not just hope that Jesus would have mercy on them. Bible says they lifted up their voices. They lifted up their voices. Somebody will lift up his voice this afternoon. I said somebody will lift up his voice this afternoon. And the Master will hear and have mercy. You cannot do that by wishful thinking. You need to lift up your voice and declare. They said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. There is mercy in the house this afternoon. I said there is mercy in the house this afternoon. It is available for all who will lift up their voice. It is available for all who will call on the Master. The people did not keep their mouth shut. It is a day of worship. It is a day of adoration. Don't keep your mouth shut. Open up and lift up your voice and call on Jehovah. Ask for his mercy. Ask for his mercy. Jehovah will hear you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know something? Look at verse 14. And when he saw them, I asked myself, was Jesus previously blind?
Was Jesus eerst blind?
Or was he walking with his eyes closed? But after they lifted up their voice and cried, the Bible says, and when Jesus saw them, there is something about your cry. There is something about your call that will attract the Lord's attention. Jesus was passing. He wasn't blind. But something attracted him to them. Hallelujah. Their call. Their cry. I tell you this afternoon, as we enter into this month of divine completion, your call will be answered. Your cry will be answered. Mercy will find you. I think mercy will find you. Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And the Bible says Jesus saw that. He wasn't blind, but the call attracted his attention. Is your call going to attract his attention this afternoon? The choice is yours. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus saw them and said unto them, go show yourself unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord gave them a spiritual instruction. Now, when you call on God, when you call upon his name, most of the time we just call upon God and go about our own and closing our ears. But normally he gives us a spiritual direction. This afternoon, I want you to expect a spiritual direction from God. Ask God to give you a spiritual direction. As you open up your mouth to worship him, as you open up your mouth to praise him, tell God, tell me that secret I need to know.
God, vertel mij het geheim wat ik wil weten.
My circumstance.
Dat mijn omstandigheden zal veranderen.
Tell me that secret I need to know.
Vertel mij het geheim
that will lead me to my breakthrough.
Dat me zal leiden.
Tell me that secret I need to know.
Vertel mij het geheim dat ik wil weten.
That will bring peace and joy to
dat
my heart and to my
en
family.
Rust in mijn
God
hart en familie zal
give doen. You a spiritual instruction.
God zal je spirituele leiding geven.
For some people today,
Vandaag de dag van sommige mensen.
God might be saying, go and forgive that brother.
Zal God zeggen, ga en vergeef deze broeder.
For some people today,
voor sommige mensen vandaag,
God might be saying, stop that life of gossip.
Zal God waarschijnlijk zeggen, stop het leven
for
met
some people today,
voor sommige mensen vandaag,
God might be saying, dedicate your body to me and
draag
your
lichaam
life of filthiness.
Aan mij en laat je leven van onreinheid.
Whatever it is.
Wat het ook is.
God will speak to you concerning a particular instruction.
God zal tot u spreken aangaande een
bepaalde instructie. And as you follow that instruction by faith.
Als u deze instructie volgt door vertrouwen en geloof.
Now when Jesus told them, go and show yourself to the priest.
Toen Jezus zei, ga en laat uzelf aan de priester zien.
Under the Jewish custom.
Onder de Joodse.
You had to be cleansed.
Moest u gereinigd worden.
Before you go, the tradition was that
de traditie was
when
dat
a leper is cleansed,
als een laatste gereinigd wordt,
and show himself
gaat
hij
zichzelf aan de priester laten
then
zien.
The priest will examine him.
En dan zal de priester hem onderzoeken.
The priest agrees that he's clean,
en nadat de priester het eens was dat hij gereinigd wordt, zal je
certificaat krijgen. Then when you go and declare now,
waar je gaat en verklaart,
kijk en heb
je certificaat van reiniging, ik ben vrij.
Halleluja.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But when God told them to go, Jesus told them to go.
Maar toen Jezus tegen hen zei, ga.
They hadn't yet experienced healing.
Daar hadden ze de genezing nog niet ervaren.
They walked in faith.
Maar ze liepen in vertrouwen.
The instruction God will give you.
De instructie dat God je
gaat geven. You probably might not see an immediate result.
Misschien zal u niet onmiddellijk resultaat zien, maar loop in vertrouwen. Maar loop in vertrouwen.
The Bible says, as they were going.
En de Bijbel zegt. Omdat ze gingen.
They realized that they were healed.
Toen realiseerden zich dat ze gereinigd waren.
As you take that step of faith,
als u die stap van vertrouwen neemt.
The Lord will visit you.
Zal de Heer u bezoeken.
The Lord will change your circumstances.
Zal de Heer uw omstandigheden veranderen.
And will glorify his name in your life.
En zal zijn naam heerlijker in uw leven.
What I noticed is that.
Wat mij is opgevallen is dat.
All these people together had faith.
Al deze mensen samen hadden vertrouwen.
And because of their faith, they were healed.
En vanwege hun geloof en vertrouwen waren ze genezen.
But there was only one.
Maar was maar één.
Who had something extra?
Die iets extra's had.
You see, in church.
Ziet u in de kerk?
There are many people with faith.
Zijn er vele mensen met vertrouwen?
There are many people sitting in the presence of God.
Er zijn vele mensen die zitten in de aanwezigheid van God.
And all those people were healed.
En al deze mensen waren genezen.
All those who have received Christ are saved.
Allemaal die Christus hebben ontvangen zijn gered.
But there is a step beyond that can bring something higher to you.
Maar er is een stap dat verder gaat die iets hogers naar je toe kan brengen.
The Bible says as they went.
De Bijbel zegt zo gingen.
They realized they were cleansed.
Realiseerden ze dat ze gereinigd waren.
And one of them.
En één van hen.
Verse 15. And one of them.
En één van hen.
When he saw.
Ziende.
That he was healed.
Dat hij genezen was.
Talking now about the power of gratitude.
Ik heb nu over de
one of them, when he saw he was healed, he turned back.
Keerde terug.
And with a loud voice.
En met een grote stem.
I said with a loud voice.
Met een luide stem.
Somebody will give a loud voice to God this afternoon. Somebody will give a high praise to God this afternoon. Because God is about to visit your home. God is about to visit your family. God is about to visit your life. Bible said the man with a loud voice.
Met een grote stem.
I've noticed something about loud voice in worshiping God.
Iets is mij opgevallen over een grote stem in het aanbidden van God. Ik kan het niet wetenschappelijk niet uitleggen. Ik kan het intellectueel ook niet uitleggen. Maar als ik de Bijbel bestudeer, het is ontdekt. Elke keer als mensen God aanbidden met een grote stem, met een luide stem, dan is het kamp van de vijand in verwarring.
And every enemy blockade in their lives is brought down.
En elke blokkade van de familie van de vijand is uit de leven verwijderd.
We realize that when they came to Jericho.
Ik realiseer dat toen ze naar Jericho kwamen.
Seven times and shout and worship him with
God had ze instructies gegeven, zeven keer lopen.
That these walls
en dan binnen met een luide stem.
No army can put down.
Deze muur dat zo dik is dat geen leger naar beneden kon halen. Ik herinner me ook een tijd dat Israël omringd was door vijanden.
And some lepers were dying.
And in Malachi,
here we see the verse again.
Here she will be in Malachi.
And they decided to visit the camp of the enemy.
And so besloten de.
But the Bible says, as they went there,
de Bijbel zegt zoals
God
op de weg had God hun stappen zo verecheld dat er groot en is iets wat er het geluid groot dat verwarring brengt in de kamp van de vijand.
The enemy said, yeah, the Israelites have gone to hire some people to come and fight with them.
Israël heeft mensen
ingevoerd om ons te bevechten.
Ze begonnen te
rennen. Ze begonnen te killing each other.
Ze begonnen
God magnify that sound. God will magnify the sound of your voice this afternoon. I said God will magnify the sound of your voice this afternoon. And the camp of your enemies will be thrown into confusion. This man came with a loud voice and glorified God. He fell down at his feet. On his face, at his feet.
Hij viel op zijn aangezicht
en
voeten. Hem dankende.
Today,
vandaag.
We will worship God with the loud voice.
Gaan we God aanbidden met grote stem. Vandaag.
We fall on our face at his
gaan we ons aangezicht aan zijn voeten
and
vallen.
Worship him.
En hem aanbidden.
And worship him.
En hem aanbidden.
Halleluja.
Halleluja.
And give thanks to him.
En hem alle dankzegging geven. En de Bijbel zegt.
Nothing in the Bible is by coincidence.
Niks in de Bijbel is per toeval.
And he was a Samaritan.
En hij was een Samaritaan.
I told you that the Samaritans and the Jews were enemies.
Dat de Samaritanen en de Joden vijanden waren.
If anybody will honor a Jewish prophet,
als iemand een Joodse profeet
zal eren,
dan zal de laatste persoon een Samaritaan zijn.
These are the people that they don't count.
Deze mensen tellen niet.
Nobody expected them.
Niemand verwacht.
Nobody respected them.
Niemand respecteerde ze.
God will turn your story around.
Maar God zal het verhaal omdraaien deze wereld.
That people could not imagine about you.
De dingen dat mensen niet konden voorstellen aangaande u. God zal het tot stand brengen.
That people could not imagine.
Ik zeg de dingen dat mensen niet konden bedenken dat jij kon behalen. God zal het tot stand brengen. Deze Samaritaan. Dat waarvan niemand verwachtte. Hij was degene die naar Jezus kwam. Je ziet het verschil. De kracht van
dankzegging.
De Bijbel zegt allemaal waren genezen. Allemaal waren genezen. Maar één kwam terug. In dankzegging. In aanbidding. En de Bijbel zegt hij werd behouden in zijn genezen.
Everybody was healed.
Iedereen was genezen.
But only one was made whole.
Was maar één behouden.
Will be made whole this afternoon.
U zal behouden worden. U zal behouden worden deze
week. Healing is only.
Ziet die genezing?
What do you call deliverance from a particular situation?
Is alleen bevrijding van een bepaalde situatie. Ze hadden malaria. Ze waren genezen van malaria.
But this man.
Maar deze man
was made whole.
Was
he had
behouden.
A holistic blessing.
Hij werd
spirit. Soul, body.
In zijn geheel werd
his mind was sound.
Zijn gedachten waren
goed. His body that was healed.
Naast zijn lichaam
his mind
dat
was sound.
Zijn gedachten waren
his
gereinigd.
Heart was at peace.
Zijn hart was tot rust
his gekomen. Finances was overturned.
Zijn financiën was omgedraaid.
Everything that was hindering him was turned over.
Alles wat hem verhinderde is
weggehaald. That is the power of gratitude.
Dat is de kracht
when
van dankzegging.
We learn to be grateful to God.
Als we leren dank te zijn.
Everything it is not only a particular circumstance.
Is dat niet alleen
it is not only a particular sickness,
niet alleen een bepaalde
but
ziekte,
we will be made whole.
Maar dat we compleet
our finances will be healed.
Onze financiën
our
zullen worden genezen.
Mental attitude will be healed.
Onze mentale instelling wordt genezen.
We will have peace of mind.
We zullen
our heart will experience joy.
Dat ons hart zal vreugde ervaren.
We are grateful to God.
Omdat we God dankbaar zijn. En dat we hem eer aandoen. Deze middag.
Learn to be grateful to God.
Leer om dankbaar
te
zijn
voor
God.
Give him honor.
Leer om hem eer te geven.
As you give him honor,
en als zoals hem eer geven.
His power will make you whole.
Zal zijn kracht u
his power
heel maken. Zal u zijn kracht u heel maken.
Because we're going to worship.
I'd
like to end here.
Zal ik hier eindigen?
And then invite, if you have your tithes.
En je uitnodigen als je tiende heeft.
Instrumentalist and choir, you can come to the stage.
Instrumentalist en choir, u kunt naar het podium komen.
This is what we're going to do. Today we also have the Lord's Supper.
Vandaag hebben we ook de
communie. First of all, I'm going to receive the tithes.
Ik ga eerst de tiende ontvangen.
Instrumentalist and choir, please. After I receive the tithes, for the sake of time, that will have enough time to worship. So, for in order that we'll have enough time to worship, after I receive the tithes, we'll immediately go and continue with our Lord's Supper.
But
this is the way we're going to do.